Hello everyone, welcome to my review and demonstration on this Bosch Unlimited Cordless Vacuum Cleaner. This machine was supplied to me from AO.com. If you want to see further details and pricing, there is a link below the video. Before I show you this cleaner in action, I thought I'd take you on a guided tour of the cleaner and all the accessories you get with this particular version. First of all, we have the machine itself. This has a rechargeable battery that can be removed for charging. Here is a separate charger, and here is the 18 volt battery you get with it. Now, the good thing about this particular Bosch is it uses powered for all batteries, so it's compatible with many Bosch cordless power tools. So you can buy spare batteries if you want to have two. You can have one constantly charged. So if you run out of power mid clean, you can slide in a new battery. And the battery just slides in at the bottom here until it clicks, and then you're ready to go. You've got a little trigger here that you don't have to actually hold down. So once you squeeze the trigger, the cleaner will stay on. And when you first switch the machine on, it's very, very quiet. That's the normal mode. So that's obviously reduced suction power. And on normal mode, you can get up to 60 minutes of runtime. However, if you're using it with the powered nozzle, that will give you up to 45 minutes runtime. But when using the powered nozzle and the turbo boost, you'll only get up to a maximum of 7 minutes. This Bosch Unlimited comes with a wall-mounted dock, so you can store the cleaner and the accessories on the wall. It won't charge when it's on the dock because obviously you charge it in the separate charger. As well as the dock, you get this very, very long, flexible crevice tool. That's ideal for your nooks and crannies, in the car, reaching up high for your cobwebs down the sides of your seats. You also get this combi nozzle, which is an upholstery nozzle, but it's also got a brush that comes out for your dusting. That's good for your Venetian blinds, lampshades, etc. You get the lightweight aluminium wand, and of course, you get the high power brush for carpets and hard floors. This powered nozzle is suitable for carpets and hard floors and has an easy to remove brush for cleaning. You simply turn this little dial here at the side and the brush comes out completely, giving you easy access. If you get pet hair or human hair wrapped around it, it's very easy to clean. Once you've cleaned it, it just slots back in. And then you turn the little padlock symbol to the locked position and you're ready to clean again. You can attach the power nozzle directly to the cleaner when cleaning carpeted stairs. And of course, you can also connect any of the other nozzles to the cleaner. And you can attach any of the tools to the end of the wand for high-level cleaning. To empty the cleaner, you press this button here and remove the whole dust compartment. Before you take out the filter, you can give this dial here a few turns. What that does is help to flick off any dust that has adhered to the filter. You then can lift out the filter unit and empty any of the debris into the bin. Now, the filter isn't washable on this machine, but Bosch say you shouldn't have to wash it. There's also a mesh screen here that comes off. You can tap that clean. It says not to wash the pleated filter, but I can't see any reason why you can't run some water through this, providing you make sure it's 100% dry before putting it back in the cleaner. Okay, so it's time for the first test, which is pet hair pickup from a short pile carpet. Now, I've harvested some hair from my Dash and Daisy, and it's pretty tenacious hair, this. It's well rubbed into the carpet. And this is a test that many vacuum cleaners can't cope with, so we'll see how this Bosch does. Now I'm going to try it first on the regular setting, down this side, forward and back, and then I'll compare it to the Bosch on turbo to see if the turbo mode makes any difference on this pet hair. So first of all, we're going to use the regular setting. And that's not done a bad job, but It looks clean, but as you can see by rubbing it, the hairs that it hasn't picked up are revealed. But considering that's on low power, that's not bad. Well, let's see by pressing the turbo button, see if the turbo button does a better job. Does look slightly better, but I'll get down again and rub the carpet. Well, it certainly made a difference. There is a little bit left, but not as much. So for tough jobs, you will need to use the turbo. This is an extreme example, of course, but even on the low power, it didn't do bad. I'm just going to pick up the rest of this on turbo mode, and then we'll see how effective this Bosch is on hard floors. Okay, so I'm in my kitchen now and I've thrown down a load of differently sized particles, which include flour, rice, rolled oats, lentils, and loose leaf tea. And again, as with the pet hair demonstration, I'm going to use the machine on normal mode down one side of the mess and then on turbo down the other side. So first of all, on normal mode, so that's a pretty good effort. No snow ploughing. It's left a little bit of the flour, but on the whole, considering that's in its low power mode, which will give you up to 45 minutes of use, that's done a pretty good job. Another couple of passes and I expect it'll pick the flour up. Okay, let's see if the increased suction on the turbo mode makes a difference. It's down here on the other side. So just have to switch into turbo. Well, interestingly enough, I would say it's slightly worse on turbo. I mean, it still left bits of the flour as it did on normal, but on turbo, there was a lot more scattering of the larger particles. I could see and hear a lot of these, especially the lentils and the rice, being scattered about. It still picked up a lot, but there's quite a lot behind me that's been scattered because I had it on turbo. So I think for this particular model, on low power is best for cleaning hard floors. Obviously, it's a bit of an extreme demo, but it's a visual aid so you can see how well this machine copes. So yes, it's very good on hard floors, even on low power. Now for a quick suction test. Onto this textured rug, I've put some rice, lentils, and rolled oats into the groove in between these carpet squares, just to see how well the Bosch Unlimited can remove all this debris. I'm going to try it on its lowest power setting. Well, on its lowest setting, it seems to have removed most of the rolled oats, so a few tiny particles left. It's left a fair amount of the lentils, as you can see, and some of the rice has also been left. But I'm going to go over it once more, but this time on turbo mode. So on turbo mode, it has removed most of the debris apart from a few grains of rice and a couple of lentils. Well, that's about the end of my video on this Bosch Unlimited Cordless Cleaner. It performs pretty well, especially on turbo mode, but obviously on turbo, you're only going to get about 7 minutes runtime. On hard floors, it seemed to work better on the normal power, which will give you up to 45 minutes. Pet hair pickup was pretty impressive. It eventually picked everything up, and again, turbo mode was best for pet hair. It's handy on the stairs, although at this price point, I would have liked to have seen a smaller motorized brush included. You only have the larger brush to use on stairs, or of course, you can use the small nozzle. It's compact and light enough for doing your day-to-day quick pickups, toast crumbs, dusting jobs, nooks and crannies, that sort of thing. It's quite substantial. It feels relatively heavy in the hand, but it is comfortable to hold. And the bugbear with some cordless cleaners, you don't have to keep your finger on the button to keep the cleaner operating. So all in all, I would put this on your short list if you're looking for a cordless cleaner at the premium end of the market. If you have any comments or questions about this Bosch, please ask in the comments section below. And there's a link below if you want to check it out on AO.com's website. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all soon. Bye for now.